Hello, welcome back. This is the second part of module 5. And it's going to be diving in even more into the DAX language. But in this part, I will do it differently. I will show you an example that I created. It has some pretty sophisticated examples of DAX formulas, which I'm going to show you. I'm not going to show you how to build them from scratch. We're going to look at them as they are now. And I'm pretty sure that also very few of you will be able to just by watching it once, just go and create your own expressions at this level. You will have access, of course, you will be able to download all the examples I'm using and look at how, and look at them more closely and gradually learn how to do things, similar things yourselves. But I wanted to do just to kind of impress you with the kind of complexity and sophistication you can get when creating business logic using DAX. So let's look at this example. I have here an Excel file. I call it a full dashboard. And it's it has actually three worksheets, each one of them showing a business aspect or a business calculation that this business wants to look at periodically. One is about year over year. So this is, I'm picking a year. I can pick the last year or I can pick a previous year. And once I pick this year, I, first of all, on the left side, I see chart with the sales of all the years. This chart here does not work with this slicer. I can actually connect, and we'll see it in another module, how to connect slicers to charts. So this chart is not connected to the slicer, so it shows all the years. By the way, if you see this chart, there's a plus minus sign here. If I click on the plus, it actually will drill into the level of months. This plus and minus here are a new feature for Excel 2016. There's also a slicer on country. And there's another one which actually slices the data because this, as you will see in a moment, this data set has data both for the company that is running this analysis and also for its competitors. It has some source for getting the competitor total sales, and it can compare the market share, calculate the market share between their sales and others. And the other vendors here, it just filters on the sales, which I call our sales. The main chart here is showing for the year that I've selected, month by month, the difference between this year and the year before. There is a sentence here, which I also build using formulas, and I'll show it to you in a moment, that says, like the total, between 2013 and 2014, the sales shrank 5%. If I go here, you see that the sales between 2012 and 2013 grew 8% total. So I built this with a bunch of Excel expressions. Some of them I will explain. And all the data comes from the actual, from the model. And for each month, you see that there are some months in which the growth, like here for March, there's a negative. So there's less sales in March of 2013 than in March of 2013. In other months, there is a growth. So month by month, I can show you the year-over-year comparisons. So let's first look at the three of them, and then I'll go to the manage window and show some of the calculations that I use here. So the second example is about calculating market share. As I said, this data set has sales both for the company called Van Arsdale and its competitors, other manufacturers. And I can see on the left side, there is a chart by country that shows in orange the sales for this company and in blue the sales for the competitors. If I select from here a segment, the chart will show, for example, for this segment, there's almost no sales for this company, it's all competitors. For this one, it's actually most of the sales are, they kind of dominate this segment of the market and so on. And again, I can open it again for an entire thing. Here on the right side, I can actually see another year over year comparison, but this time of the year over year change in the market share. So for you see that market share, there was in 2012, it was better than before, 2013. 2011, there is no data because there is the first data in this data set, so it doesn't have any year over year comparisons. And 2014, there actually was, and also in 2015, there is actually a drop in the market share compared to previous years. And again, it can be calculated for a specific or for a specific segment or for all segments. So this is the other aspect that they want to always look at. This is the their market share in the different areas that they operate in. And the last one, and maybe the most advanced one, is what I call expansion. I have information here about sales for, as you remember, we have zip codes in countries. And every year they're getting into new territories, selling into more zip codes, which correspond to cities and states and so on. So I want to show here how many new locations by zip code they are selling for a specific country or for all countries. If I just click on the USA, you see that where the first year, of course, have all the locations are new because this is just the beginning of this data set. But for 2012, there were over 4,000 new zip codes that had some sales in this year, but did not have any sales in the previous year. When you look at the total locations, you will see that the total growth is actually negligible because as they were selling into new ones, they had some areas in which and they had sales in the previous year and not in this year. So, but all this, of course, is fictional data. It just shows you the ability to calculate. And this could be the same about customers, acquiring customers. How many customers do we have that have bought something in this period, but nothing in previous periods? And I can also go and on the pivot. Now here I have a pivot table and I have a pivot charts connected to it. And they correspond to each other. So if I go here and I click on the plus sign, it will go and open up for months. And also this chart will respond in the same way. Now I see for each month how many new, so if there are like, let's say in the US, 705 new zip codes that had registered some sales in March, it means that those zip codes did not have any sales in any one of the months in 2011 or in 2012 up to March. So here it's acquiring territories by zip. It could be the same way for customers themselves. And also in similar ways, you can calculate repeating customers that have bought in the previous period and also in the period that we are looking at. So they are repeating customers. And also you can see customers that actually have bought something in the past but did not show up any new sales in this period. So this depends on the definition for each business. It seems like these customers are actually lost. So these are the three scenarios, and let's look at a few, at least, of the examples of how do I calculate all these KPIs, these things in DAX. So here is this, the sales table. Oh, one more thing that actually I was able to do and I didn't show up and tell you, and it was here. I have here a slicer that enables me to select for the chart on the left side, how do I want to see it? I want to see it as a total percentage from the, or I want to see absolutely the sales for all the competitors together and this company together. So two ways to see the same thing, selecting it from a slicer, which is another technique I'm using here to allow the user to select things that will affect the way the visualization looks. So we won't have time probably to look at all the expressions here. Some of them are pretty complex, but let's at least see a few of them. So the first one, total revenue, is basically the basic one. It's the sum of the revenue. We saw this before. It's a simple calculation, but all the others are actually based on this measure. So the second one I want to show you is this one. And this one is the one that is calculated, it's called our sales, and it's using the calculate function. If you remember the calculate function, it first, it receives a expression, and then it receives one or more filters. In this case, it filters the data where the manufacturer column from the manufacturer table is, have this text, Van Arsdale. This is the name of our company, the company that runs this analysis. So our sales is just our, the sales for this company. Based on, and there's another one here next to it, it's called sales all vendors, which is using a function we already met before, which is called all, and it's doing calculate of total revenue for all the manufacturers. And as you can expect, similar to what we saw before, there is a divide function that divides our sales by all sales. And this is actually the definition of market shares. The sales of our company divided by the sales of all the manufacturers together gives a percentage, and this can be sliced, as we saw, by segment, by period of time, by anything we want. So it still corresponds to the rest of the filter contents. So these were the measures required to calculate the market share. Let's now look at something more complex, and will be the last thing that we're going to look here. And this is this function. It looks a little bit, it has in the middle a function with a very long name. And, but the principle is similar. This is the function that calculates sales in the year before the period that's, it's part of the context. So if the context selects the year 2013, this function will return the sales in 2013. If we select 15, it will show 14 and so on. So this is always going to return the sales the year before. Now, the way the calculate works here is that, first of all, it uses the total revenue in the same way. And then it uses the same period last year, and the same period last year gets as a, as an argument all the values in the column date from the calendar. So remember the calendar, it has a column called date. I gave the function all the dates. Let's say if I'm filtering on a year, I gave it all the years, the days in this year. And in return, this function created transformation and shifts the dates 1 year backwards. So as a, as a return table, this function gets a table and returns a table. And the table is the same days that it got as input, but only shifted 1 year back. When I give it to the calculate function will say, okay, now I have to calculate the total revenue, but with a modified context. And the modified context is the period, the same days last year. Now, once I have this, and I can do the same divide the function thing with, like I used before with a divide, saying total revenue minus last year revenue divided by last year revenue actually showed me the growth, negative or positive, between last year and this year. So you see that the pattern repeats itself. We use calculate to create the denominator, and then we can use it to create the final measure that we want to show. So this are all the measures that I wanted to go into and show you. There are some more, and you will be able to look at them. And if we have questions, you will have the forum that we can, you can ask further questions. And I hope this will be a good start for you to dive in more depth into DAX. This will be the level of DAX that we are going to reach in this series. And thanks, and see you in the next module.